Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. Here we'll see how to send notification to a specific user or to a specific device. Now to be able to do that, first make sure that you call this request permission method, which you can call it anything, but in the body itself you'd have this instance, Firebase messaging instance, and you save it in a variable, and then you call a method which is called request permission, and after that you check the request whether you really get the permission or not. Okay, that's the first step. And after that we have another method which is called get token. Now this get token actually gets the device token, because if we want to be able to send notification to a specific device, a specific user, first you have to get the device token, which means the hardware token. In this case is the emulator token, but in real scenario it would be a real hardware token. But this method is same regardless this is an emulator or a real Android device or real iOS device. The idea is same. Anyway, so we get it and then we save it in a variable which is called m token. So here we save it, but at the same time actually we also want to save it to a Firebase backend or Firebase console. So over here first we check if we have a collection or not. If we have the collection, then we check for a document, but document is actually our user, certain user or username, and for that username actually in the document we have a field which is called token, and we save that token in this field. Now we'll go ahead and take a look at this token field and user tokens and user. Here I see we have our collection which is called user tokens, then we have a user two which we have just seen now, and that for user we have this token. Once again, this is a hardware or device token. So this is how you get token and save it. So once we have the token, we saved it in Firebase database, and then we are good to go. So the last method or the last step to send a certain notification to a certain device, we have to create a method. The method name is called send push message. Now this is the message that does the trick or work to send a notification to a user. Now of course this method should be get called on an on click event or a gesture detector or inkwell or any kind of clickable widget. So in our case this is the clickable button over here. Now this button actually inside a widget, so this button is actually inside gesture detector. Now here is our gesture detector, and inside this gesture detector you see that we have this send push message. Now over here first we visit our Firebase collection which is called user token, and we get username from our device. Now of course this username is like, for example, user 2, which is this one, typed in over here, and you can also type in here like this is a title, this is a body, like that. So anyway, so if we type in the user like this, so we get the username over here, and for based on that user we get the token. As you can see, it's visiting our Firebase token collection which we have seen over here. So it comes over here, try to find that user. For user we get the token. Once you get the token, then we get actual the token field, and we save it in a variable, and once we save it, then we send it to this method. Now this method is taking token, body and title, which is now in this case, so token would be coming from Firebase backend, and then this is the title and this is the body. And interestingly enough, we also have to use a HTTP post method from our app. So this is our HTTP post method. Now inside this method actually we have few sections. The first one is it takes the URI. Now this is quite important. So this is the URI endpoint where we want to post our message, including this user related device token. And then we also have this authorization code in the header. The first one is JSON or content type, and the second is authorization. Now this is the server key that we have to get. Where do you get this server? To be able to get this server key, first you have to come over here, project overview, then you select your device, Android or iOS, it doesn't really matter, and then come over here inside this cloud messaging, and inside this you will get this server key. Okay, so this is the authorization key, the one we have seen just now over here. So this is the server key, but you have to remember, you have to put right after key equal, and then you put your server key, and then you are good to go. All right, so this is our headers. So headers contain content type and authorization, and after that we'll have a body. Now the body itself takes JSON information over here, as you can see. Anyway, so inside this we have this map. Now inside the map, actually we have some settings. So we have data and as well as notification sections. Okay, now at the same time, as you see, we are sending both body and title, body and title over here. Now most importantly, we are sending this message, this information to this token. Now once again, what is this token? This token is this one. So because of this token, we'll be able to send notification to a specific device. So now what we'll do, we'll go ahead and click on this button and we will see that we get the notification from Firebase. As you see, we got it. Okay, so that's how you use, that's how you send a notification to a specific user. The core idea is you have to get this endpoint, then you have to get this authorization, and after that you send whatever the data you want, but at the same time you have to make sure that you have the right token. Thank you so much.